Hi everybody, it's James here at From the Anvil. Hope everybody is doing well. I am back to do opposition and cover between West Ham United versus Chelsea this Saturday in the early kickoff at the London Stadium. I love a good London derby. I love it when Chelsea come up against West Ham. Always memorable moments. Whether it be, well, Andriy Yarmolenko's late winner in a 3-2 win last July, or it be David Martin making his Premier League debut at 33 years old and keeping a clean sheet in a 1-0 win. West Ham always has something memorable when it comes to playing Chelsea. It's a game that I always look forward to because, like I said, it's a London derby. There's a lot of, there's a lot of intensity about the players. There's a lot of passion. And there's a big rivalry that comes about it as well. Look, Chelsea right now, team to beat in the Premier League, top in the league, have been doing all season, and as it stands, they're going to win the league, and they're just blowing a lot of teams out of the water as well. I'm still looking forward to the game, though, even if it does mean I've got to wake up at like 5 o'clock in the morning mountain time here in Canada, but whatever, I'll happily get up for it, and hopefully West Ham can get a good result out of this. In a nutshell, about Chelsea. Chelsea's had a phenomenal season in all competitions, but it's the Premier League, really, that the team started to show a lot of fight, passion, attractive football, and high-energy attack. Chelsea's only lost one game all season. That was against Manchester City, which is understandable because City's the arguably now the second-best team, or even the third-best team to Chelsea right now this season. But everything about this Thomas Tuchel team is absolutely perfect and screwed on. The fact that the defence has been really crucial. Edward Mendy keeping 7 clean sheets in the Premier League so far this season is a big thing. And also, it's just Tuchel's overall philosophy that he's been very quick to install on the whole team. This is what I think it is with Chelsea. They go through a lot of managers who are European-class managers in terms of silverware, but they never get anybody who can be like a long-term success. They had it with Jose Mourinho. That is true. But his second spell wasn't as successful as his first spell, even if he did win a Premier League title 6 months before he was sacked in 2015. What I will say about Chelsea is they needed somebody who could really know about the club, and they got that within Frank Lampard. And Lampard made good use of the academy, not at least because he used players such as Mason Mount and Tammy Abraham. But in the long run, Lampard wasn't someone who could win a hell of a lot of silverware with Chelsea. And when Thomas Tuchel came into the club, it was a bit of a no-brainer appointment because he's a proven winner in Europe. He's proven to have his own kind of style of coaching in the sense that he likes to tinker with his tactics a lot and he always likes to push up the ball forward. Within months of him becoming Chelsea manager, Chelsea had won a Champions League, and at the current moment in time, the top in the Premier League right now, and the whole team is like one very tight, disciplined unit. What it is with the attacking system at Chelsea is that it likes to be very progressive. If you're talking coming from the back, it used to be usually the fullbacks who would attack, but Tuchel wants the centre-backs more to be a bit more deeper. He likes to play deeper football. That's why Jorginho works very well in the system. Players like Mason Mount who can transition between that holding midfield, defensive midfield zone to more of the attacking flanks. They also have a lot of physicality in the team as well. They are very strong players physically and mentally. And Tuchel, like I say, likes to experiment a lot. And it takes him time to find out what he really can get out of this Chelsea team. But I think he's done really well so far. Yeah, he's a great head coach. He's won tournaments in different countries in major leagues. He's got a lot of good experience in the Champions League as well. Chelsea should be lucky to have him as a head coach. And I'm hoping for them that he can be a success in the long run, but I don't wish Chelsea luck on Saturday for obvious reasons. Look, Chelsea's now a very good team. Like I say, it's team to beat right now. It's very competitive team to play against, and everybody wants to beat him just for that confidence boost. West Ham's winless in three games. So going into this game against Chelsea is not ideal, but at the same time, it's a perfect opportunity to get that confidence boost back and get some points from this. So that's the 50-50. As for Chelsea, they just want to strengthen their, you know, lead on the top. I mean, at the time of recording right now, Chelsea's still topping the league. But not only that, it's the fact that they're top just by 1 point and they have a plus 27 goal difference. They've got the best goal difference. So the second best goal difference, actually, after Liverpool. And they're keeping clean sheets and the tight defensively solid up front as well. It's like the perfect unit of a team. And that's why I'm reckoning that they're going to win the Premier League. I'm going to say that right now. As for my three players to watch, this was not difficult to choose. Just when we thought Romelu Lukaku was done with and that West Ham would never, ever have to suffer from Belgian Bautista ever again, Chelsea went and re-signed him. Yeah, couldn't believe it. £100 million as well from Inter Milan, because Inter Milan was skint and, you know, Lukaku's known at Chelsea and Tuchel's like, oh, let's go and anoint West Ham fans. Yeah. What minute do we reckon Lukaku's going to score his goal then? Eight? Actually, he's probably going to get two. Maybe even three, because it's West Ham. Oh, you know, Lukaku actually hasn't been, you know, that massive, really, in terms of his scores. Oh, he's got three goals in the Premier League this season so far. Oh, come West Ham. He's probably going to get a couple against us, right? And then, you know, we don't know how to deal with him. And I actually worry, if Craig Dawson starts, Dawson's going to get put on his ass by Lukaku. He won't be able to fight off Lukaku. Lukaku is one of the best strikers in the world. Physical, strong, great left foot, real goal poaching instinct. He's going to have an absolute field day against us if we don't lock him down. So Lukaku is obviously my first choice because he's got a bit of a history with West Ham. Even when he was at Everton, he had it. Secondly, Edward Mendy has to go in this. One of the best goalkeepers in Europe as well. He's had a blinding season in the Premier League and the Champions League too. Four clean sheets in the Champions League, seven in the Premier League. Mendy has been everything that Chelsea fans thought Kepa would be. Kepa was too much of a liability for the money he was paid. Mendy, you know, West Ham was actually, and I'm going to get this right now, I've just thought of this, West Ham was actually linked with a move for him back in 2018. No disrespect, Fabianski, man, but we was linked with a move for Mendy. We could have had an absolute baller of a goalkeeper here. That was genius from Manuel Pellegrini, wasn't it, Chile and Chris Hughton? Yeah. Great, well done for not signing Mendy. Bet you right now Chelsea fans are loving him. He's good at keeping consecutive clean sheets as well. And here was the thing. He kept four clean sheets in the opening five games of the Premier League season. He then kept three consecutive clean sheets in the month of October. And his last clean sheet came against Leicester in a 3-0 away win. So the man is just a solid wall and a commanding goalkeeper. And thirdly, is the man who was third place in the Ballon d'Or nominations. I still kind of don't know how. I mean, he's a quality player, but I don't know how. He was above Salah and players of that like. Jorginho. Versatile, intelligent, tactically aware, and a deep-lying playmaker. Jorginho is also reliable at penalties, so we better not concede any Saturday. Thomas Tuchel has transformed Jorginho into one of the best midfielders in the world. I was saying it actually before, and I was saying to myself, you know, Jorginho's going to be up there with one of the best midfielders in the world, and Tuchel's now confirmed that. He's so important to that Chelsea team because of his influence in creating plays. The fact that he will aim to find teammates where he can and make those plays happen. So those are my three players. Lukaku, Mendy, Jorginho. Massive threats. Although I could go on about the whole team, really. Those are my three choices. As for a player who played for both, well, Kurt Zouma. It's going to feel weird him playing against Chelsea, actually. Because don't forget, those are his former employers. He spent many, many years at Stamford Bridge. And in that time, he was used to winning things. He actually spent 7 years in West London via some loan spells at St Etienne, Stoke City and Everton. But, you know, in that time, he was a very popular player, won 2 Premier League titles, won a Champions League as well, was Chelsea's Young Player of the Year for the 14-15 season. Zouma was really, when he was in his early days at Chelsea, one of the most highly rated centre-backs in the Premier League. Now he's at West Ham. He's now our best centre-back because Ogbonna's gone. Ogbonna and Zouma formed an immense partnership. And now we don't have that anymore because Ogbonna's out. So Zouma has gone from being a... from being, shall we say, blue to claret and blue. But anyway, I hope Chelsea fans don't slag him off. He was a great player for you lot. If you're watching this and you're a Chelsea fan, give him all the respect. Because West Ham fans love him and we're glad we've got him. And we will look after him. As for my score prediction, going to say loss. Absolutely, I'm going to say a loss for this because I can't see West Ham beating Chelsea. I can't. Even though we do well against them, I'm going to say 3-1 to Chelsea. I mean, West Ham have got to make changes. We've been saying Lanzini's been knocking on the door for a starting place. And yeah, he has. Will he start though? I don't know. Dawson will need to come out. I'd rather have Diop in for this game. Even though he's not as physical as Zouma, we need to have a change in defence. We need to change something in that team right now. And how do we contain Chelsea? Well, I don't want a 5 at the back. That's the biggest problem. We can't have 5 at the back because it doesn't work. It stops us from going forward. So there's a lot of decisions we've got to make. Moyes has got to decide who starts, who drops, and what formation he's got to play when Chelsea comes into town. Because I don't know what's going to happen, really. But I can see Chelsea winning this 3-1, and I'm calling a 3-1 win to Chelsea. Thank you very much for watching this episode of Opposition Uncovered. If you like it, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more content, everybody. I'm going to have to get up early for the game, but hopefully I can get a post-game view redone. Hopefully get my review done of the game. Sorry, I slipped my words there a bit. And time after the final whistle has blown. Take care, everybody. Thank you very much for watching this, and I will see you all on Saturday, hopefully.